Here today again we have gathered on the platform of learning academic session. Today pandemic can mark into an opportunity. This what India have determined with and proved it with its potential to the world. And being an Indian, I'm really proud of it. So today I will going to discuss with one of the topic that is the most crucial and recent in the hour, that is Atmanirbhar Bharat, evaluation of economic stimulate. This Atmanirbhar Bharat, self-reliant India, self-sufficient India, which is an aim, and the personality behind the introduction is the Honorable Prime Minister of India, Mr. Narendra Modi, and the person who have announced package and delivered the blueprint is now in front of you. And he have delivered it with the help of Finance Minister and the Independent State Finance Minister, Mrs. Nirmala Sitaraman and Mr. Anurag Thakur. Here he marked it on 12th May that India has a vast potential to deliver in the world economy and India will emerge as China's alternative. So here is the introduction what he mentioned. On 12th May, Indian economy was injected with 20 lakh crore rupees package. This announcement was made to have an objective of tough competition in global supply chain, empowering women, poor, laborers, migrant with an economic aid to deliver the world with great traditional and heritage of culture of India. He marked go global with local products, with your tradition, with your culture, with your historical heritage, and I will cater the economy with huge investment through the press conferences of Finance Minister and Finance Ministry and Commerce Ministry, Industry Ministry. They will join in a coordination to deliver you a self-sufficient India. The five conferences press released, Finance Minister and the Ministry associated with others have given an economic development. Increase in borrowing limit, privatization of public sector, collateral free loans for business, increase the investment. Then MSMEs are promoted to deliver you with employment opportunities. Non-banking finance cooperation came in existence. Atmanirbhar Bharat, self-reliant India in infrastructure, and the road ahead is there. I have shared one press conference of the Finance Minister to deliver you a better understanding. Atmanirbhar Bharat focus on
Again for the last 2 months, just to give you reassurance that some of the dates which we had extended for fisheries related activities, because many of them had overseas contracts in getting the brood stock or in getting some of the consignments which were coming from abroad, all the deadline extensions have been honored. The validity for SIPs, sanitary import permits for import of shrimp brood stock, was extended by 3 months. We have also condoned the delay of 1 month in the arrival of brood stock consignments. And for all the quarantine cubicles which were booked, but because of the delays, they were going to have to forfeit the monies that they paid, we allowed rebooking at no extra or additional charge. All this has been respected, and also the verification of the documents for grant of NOC for quarantining has also been relaxed from 7 days to 3 days. So very many measures which will help shrimp farmers, marine farmers, and also coastal farmers, which were given the kind of extension because of the lockdown, have all been extended duly, and help and assistance have been extended as promised. So I want to underline the fact that registration of 242 registered shrimp hatcheries and also rearing hatcheries were expiring on 31st March. They have been extended by another 3 months without any additional burden on them. So such operations also of the marine capture fisheries and aquaculture have also been relaxed to cover inland fisheries and hatcheries.
पिछले 2 महीनों में 242 नई श्रिम्प हैचरीज को रजिस्ट्रेशन दी गई और जो रियरिंग हैचरी जिनकी एक्सपायरी 31 मार्च को हो रही थी उसको 3 महीने की एक्सटेंशन दे दी गई है, और बाकी ऑपरेशंस भी मरीन कैप्चरिंग के लिए जो थे उनको और एक्वाकल्चर के लिए जो रिलैक्सेशन देनी थी वो भी दी गई, और जो 4 घोषणाएं हमने इनको लेकर पहले की थी उनको भी लागू कर दिया गया है मत्स्य पालन को लेकर।
आई गो टू टुडेज अनाउंसमेंट्स, द थर्ड ट्रांच कवरिंग एग्रीकल्चर। First eight steps are towards money is going for infrastructure capacity building, and from among the eight, so the first one is we provide 1 lakh crore for aggregators, FPOs, primary agriculture cooperative societies, farmer producer organizations which are mentioned FPOs, all for strengthening the farm gate infrastructure. Farm gate infrastructure are cold chains, post-harvest management infrastructure, storage centers, yards from where they have to do it. So this fund for 1 lakh crore is being created. Here private entrepreneurs, agricultural entrepreneurs, startups, all of whom are now looking at facilitating by procuring from the farmers and reaching out with value addition to the global markets, don't have the infrastructure. So this fund for 1 lakh crore will immediately address that issue, and that fund will be created at the earliest.
Now, hereby coming back to the topic, 4 engines of the economy have a vast effect on the development of any nation. First one, individual household expenditure that give birth to business investment through their demand. Then the business investments have the part of taxes and other duties or compulsory payments towards government, and then government expenditure marks it with the betterment of social society and your economic phase. So here in the pandemic, 2 pillars are missing, as due to COVID-19 pandemic, income cycle comes down. So there is very less demand, which is in the form of household expenditure. Second, when expenditure is low, so investment will ultimately going to fall and postponed due to the low demand. So here the government have catered this world with Indian economy management in health crisis with a government expenditure from the treasure, and they have introduced you with betterment of 4th engine, that is international trade. Suffering of restriction due to pandemic spread marked you with bit restriction, but they have given you a brilliant platform constructed to mark an international investment in your country, as China's foreign trader or a investor is losing faith in them. The one thing you can discover over there is your brilliant opportunity to cater the world with the second manufacturing hub, that is your own country, India, because we have cheap labor and a better infrastructure to cater the world and to address the population migration at the perfect timing management with China's lost investors' faith to gain attraction of investment, and they can supply us additional capital. But still, we are talking about global and domestic demand, so we are lagging behind here. We do not have marketing strategy. So India just have to function on marketing strategy. Here today I'm concluding it here only, then I will have another series of discussion that I will bring later. Thank you for visiting, and I see you soon as again.